Hey there guys, welcome to Cinema 4 YouTube channel. My name is Ken. Today we're gonna take a quick look at something that just arrived in the mailbox very recently. This is the Holga Digital Camera. As some of you guys may have remembered, the Holga Digital Camera was one of the hot items on the Kickstarter project list last year. And me being a camera enthusiast, I pre-ordered one on the project and became one of the investors on it. And we just received this end of last week and took a quick spin with this guy right here in the past day or so. And so far, the cameras, from the looks of it, it's a complete, almost like a mini clone version of the film version of the original Holga camera, with the exception that this camera is significantly smaller. It's about, it's the size of my inside of my palm. This would be, I would say, about half of the size of an actual original film version of the Holga camera. The sensor of this camera actually gives you approximately about 8 megapixel. Dynamic range is definitely not great. Comparing to the quality you would get from your smartphone would definitely blow this camera completely out of the water. On top, there's this dial in which you can, it's between the off mode, and then you have 135mm mode and then 120mm mode. The 135mm basically makes it look like a 4:3 aspect ratio. And then the 120 basically give you a 1:1 square, which is more like the original Holga film camera in which you're using a 120 film, and give you a square format. The 135, I do notice is you would get some vignetting in the corner. Versus for the 120, it looks like they took the exact same picture except just crop in on it, so you don't have the same kind of vignetting issue of it. But I would see it less than an issue, but more like almost like a quote-unquote feature. On the front here, you would see it has like a little button here where you can switch between daylight mode, and then this one is like an indoor mode. And as you can see in some of the sample photos, switching between the two, actually, there is a slight difference between the color-white balance. I would assume it's for the indoor to kind of compensate for in case if you use like incandescent lights. Versus for outdoor, they deal with more like a daylight white balance. Another thing with the outdoor and indoor mode is that this is the way that you can choose between f2.8 mode and f8 mode, in which the outdoor is going to be f8 mode, and then the indoor mode is going to be f2.8. But testing it with a flash, I've mounted a SB910 flash to it, setting the mode to be automatic at ISO 100 f2.8, and mounting it on top of the hot shoe and then shooting with it between the daylight mode and indoor mode, the exposure doesn't seem to have a lot of difference effect on it. One thing it could be that the camera automatically compensate for indoor mode or outside mode in terms of what kind of ISO they're using. Because looking at the instructional manual, they actually don't tell you what kind of ISO this camera actually operate as. And I just kind of, on the flash, I just kind of assume it going at ISO 100, and that's the setting I've set the flash into. On here, you see a little lever over here. Pressing that is actually the shutter button. So when you just hold it, click it just like that, it actually, the shutter speed is 1/60th, versus if you hold it down for a long period of time, that is actually the bolt mode, in which you can kind of do a countdown yourself to see what kind of long exposure you can get from it. I've tested it, it doesn't exactly go as the seconds that I was counting it. Say for example, I was holding it down for like a 10 second exposure. From the looks of it, it's more like a 5 or 6 second exposure that I ended up getting. So it's not an exact science, or either that or I haven't done it properly, but it's part of the quirkiness of the camera, in which it's what the Holga camera is kind of advertising it for. Over here you see a optical viewfinder in which you can see through the viewfinder and see what kind of frame line you're getting. When you hold down the shutter, the red button actually turns on, indicating that you're taking a photo. So that's kind of like, if you don't see the light flashing, it means it's actually not taking a photo itself. So that's that red light feature is actually comes in pretty handy. Looking at the bottom over here, you have two separate modes again. You can select either a black and white mode or a color mode. The black and white mode, I find the black and white conversion of it is pretty flat. I actually prefer to shoot in color mode, and in the end just convert it to black and white myself, either through editing software on the phone or on the computer. Now looking at the bottom here, they have a slot for your memory card. This is using a regular SD card slot, and you can this camera apparently also support a wireless SD card feature. So if you want to know a little bit more about, I believe on the digital Holga website, they actually indicate which memory card they actually support. So you can go on there and look for more information if you want to use a wireless one. For me, I just simply use like a regular SD card that I don't no longer use. Keep in mind, I believe the camera only support up to 32 gig SD card. So if you end up using a 64 gig card, the camera may not read it properly. So directly next to the SD card slot, you got a micro USB port right over here. You can connect the camera directly up to your computer. I believe this is only for file transfer, but for myself, I'm more used to using a card reader myself, so it's a little bit easier for my workflow. And over here, you get your little slot for your two AA battery that used to operate the camera itself. And right along down the middle, there's a plastic built tripod fret mount. So if you're using like an older kind of tripod that might have a sharper fret on the metal screw on the tripod, you might want to be a little bit more careful when you fret the camera in, because if you don't do it properly, you might actually fray the fret mount on your tripod mount itself. And on top of here, there's a regular hot shoe, and as I've mentioned before, I mounted a SB910 flash onto it, so I can say that the hot shoe flash works perfectly with any kind of flash that you have. Granted, I would suggest only using a more current, up-to-date flash instead of like an old flash that you may have from your film camera. One reason is because some of the older flashes that they use, because it's a film camera with a lot less microchip or any kind of computerized system inside a camera, they might have a much higher trigger voltage. Versus like current days digital camera like SLR, they're more so using a 5 volts kind of triggering voltage. Instead of the older one, it could go up to 10 or much, much higher. And if you end up using an older film flash that have a much higher trigger voltage, it might actually fry your camera. So in conclusion, the pros of this camera, it's kind of neat, kind of nifty. Not a great image quality, but you're definitely buying a pretty reminiscence of like a digital version of a Holga camera itself. Con-wise, this is definitely not your day-to-day regular camera. When you're using this, you're going for the quirkiness of the product itself. And if you're interested in that, it's not bad for the price that you're paying. I mean, it's not that much different than a very, very base model point-and-shoot camera, but you can get quite a bit of fun out of this little guy. But if you're already used to what you get from a smartphone, kind of play with all the filters and the little things from your smartphone itself, stick with that. Leave this behind, because this is going to be like a lot more restrictive in terms of what kind of option you can deal with and what kind of choices you can deal with. Again, that's a quick review and overview of the Holga camera itself. My name is Ken. Thank you for watching Cinema 4 TV, and we'll catch you around next time.